Tom Foolerys Adventure Park just opened last month at the brand new Kalahari Resort in Round Rock, Texas. This indoor amusement park is the second Tom Foolerys park after the original one in the Wisconsin Dells, and this park feels like an upscale family entertainment center. In this video, I'll provide a general overview of the park, and hopefully this review will help you determine if this park is worth visiting. Tom Foolerys is attached to the Kalahari Resort in Round Rock, Texas. If you're traveling between Six Flags Over Texas and the Dallas area to the San Antonio area amusement parks, you will pass right by this Kalahari Resort. You can either enter the park through its own designated entrance, or you can enter through the hotel. If you access Tom Foolerys using the ladder, you enter the park on the second level and take an escalator down to the main floor where most of the rides and attractions are. It's a pretty cool reveal, and it's similar to what you see at the Nickelodeon Universe Park at the American Dream Mall in New Jersey. And one odd thing, if you want to access the indoor water park currently, I believe the only way to do so is to walk through the entirety of Tom Foolerys, as the water park entrance is in the very back of the park. For this reason, Tom Foolerys has free admission. This is similar to a lot of other family entertainment centers. And then you have a lot of different options depending upon what you want to experience. You can purchase game cards for just the arcade games, you can purchase individual ride and attraction tickets, or you can purchase an unlimited wristband. And one interesting note, even if you're a hotel guest at the Kalahari, you do not get free wristbands to Tom Foolerys. Only the water park is included for hotel guests. I found that sort of odd, but maybe it was a way to limit the crowds. An all-day wristband will cost adults $45, and small children $25. If you arrive after 5 p.m, you get a $5 discount on both these rates. If you're a Kalahari hotel guest, you can get the all-day wristband for the price of an after 5 p.m. wristband, so it isn't that much of a money saver staying at the resort. You also can purchase a combo pass with the indoor water park that will save you a few dollars if you're a non-resort guest. Every attraction is included on the wristband except the escape rooms, bowling alley, and arcade games. If you want to pay per ride, the kids' rides will cost you $5 a piece, the adult rides will cost you anywhere from $7 to $10, and the ropes course or escape room will cost you $15. One of the strong suits of this park are the incredibly long hours. Since the park has just opened, they are still fine-tuning their hours, but the park appears to be open most days by 9 or 10 a.m., and it seems to stay open until 11 or 12 at night. Just note that the amusement rides tend to open an hour after the arcade and close an hour before the arcade. Again, these could change, but these are accurate as of this recording. Not only do the rides close early, but they will also close periodically throughout the day. This appeared to be due to staffing, which I understand. Most cases, there was just a rotating ride operator floating between attractions, but in some instances, rides were closed for an hour straight. I just wish the park provided a schedule of guests notifying them when attractions would close for an extended period of time so you could plan ahead. I arrived at a few attractions just to find paper signs saying they were closed for an hour. When the employees were staffing the rides, they were fairly efficient and most were quite friendly. That's always a good sign to see from a new park. While I didn't play any of the arcade games, the collection seemed extremely modern and reminiscent of what you'll find at a Dave & Buster's. And the bright lights and sounds of the arcade games combined with the amusement rides was extremely overwhelming. The place felt alive and was busting at the seam with kinetic energy. That's especially true since the park's star attraction, the Screamin' Centipede roller coaster, is located smack dab in the middle of the park. This is one of the first SBF Visa Big Air coasters to open, which combines their familiar spinning coaster, suitable for families, with a thrilling hamster wheel. I posted a separate review going into more detail on this ride, but while the concept is brilliant on paper, the execution is a bit flawed in my opinion. For a spinner to be effective, you want a twisting layout. For a hamster wheel to be effective, you want more elevation changes over twists and turns. I think the layout here works well for the spinning cars, but the hamster wheel suffers from the finale being uncomfortable as you're suspended upside down while you're rounding an unbanked turn. Thankfully, the restraints are super soft and cushiony, but it's still an unpleasant ending. The coaster is unique though, and the hamster wheel has one thrilling flip each lap, plus a stall, so it's worth trying. And one other note here, I believe the park will force a no-loose article policy on this ride, as they have banks of lockers set up by the attraction. However, the lockers were broken the day I visited, so they were permitting guests to bring their belongings onto the ride platform. The other coaster here is the Star Force Orbiter SBF Visa Micro Coaster. The ride is among the tamest kiddie coasters out there, but it works well for kids, and adults are allowed to ride without any issue if you're seeking an extra coaster credit. Most of the flat rides are targeted towards kids, but you do have one notable one in the Red, White, and Woo, which is one of the first Zamperla Nebulas to open. These are incredibly mesmerizing attractions with the arms constantly spinning and coming mere feet from each other. And if you haven't ridden one of these, they're enjoyable rides. They're not super intense, nor do they offer as much airtime as I expected, but the visuals from the near misses are really cool. The rest of the attractions are similar to what you'll find at other family entertainment centers across the country. You have a decent indoor ropes course, you have several rock walls of varying difficulties, and you have a back area with several other attractions such as laser tag, a mirror maze, escape rooms, and a Triotech shooting motion simulator. Now, I visited on a weekday, so the park was fairly empty. On a busy day, I could only see two rides garnering lengthy waits. One would be the ropes course, depending upon how many guests they allow to experience it at once and how long you're allowed to stay up there. The second would be the Screamin' Centipede Hamster Wheel. While there are four spinning cars seating a total of 16 guests, there is only one hamster wheel per train that seats just two riders. And since the ride has a 1.5 to 2 minute cycle and then takes another 1 or 2 minutes to load, you can quickly see how the line could become an issue on a busy day. So do I recommend visiting Tom Foolery's Adventure Park? I think it's a no-brainer if you're staying at the Kalahari already, as the wide range of attractions appeal to guests of all ages. I think younger guests would easily be able to spend an entire day here, while older guests would probably be content spending an hour or two at most. Coaster enthusiasts specifically should probably put Tom Foolery's on their itinerary if they're on a Texas theme park trip. Round Rock is in the middle of the road between Dallas and San Antonio, so you can stop into this park either before or after Six Flags or SeaWorld. And there aren't many big air coasters out there right now, so even if I personally think the hamster wheel is a bit flawed on this particular layout, it's still a relatively unique ride experience at this time. So those are my thoughts on the Tom Foolery's Adventure Park, the newest indoor amusement park in the country. What are your thoughts on this park? Have you been there, or have you been to the original location, the Wisconsin Dells? I would love to hear what you think down in the comments about this park. If you enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate if you gave it a like and you considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster and amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.